But yeah, I remember me, Dorian Weeks, Jamai Donaldson, Sharon Batiste, Keelan Mitchell, yeah, all of you. I remember a time on the YTC to take us and we went to see the optometrist, you know? And all of you went through the whole AEIOU cover your eye symptoms. And then we waited patiently for the glasses, and then all of you had on glasses. And then seeing some of the so-called bad examples in YTC wearing glasses, it was like, yo, it's cool to be a nerd, you know what I mean? Going all of the classes and just determined. I feel that was my most determined point in my life. You know, more time to focus on not just music or poetry, more time to focus on self. Jamai Donaldson, he was bright like bulb, you know what I mean? He didn't have the image of a nerd, but this dude was a nerd. Biology, chemistry, I mean, he would sit down and call out the whole periodic table for you, like one after the other, you know what I mean? Dorian Weeks would play basketball, football, rugby with the same passion, the same energy, and the same skill, you know? That time, I feel everyone deserves or should put themselves in place to get that moment of solitude. You know what I mean? Some of us are forced into solitude, you know what I mean? And we don't appreciate it because we don't know that it's really solitude. They come there for you, watch it like, hey, you get locked up and no, man. Sometimes you just had to digest it and look around at the situation and know that it's you to make something better happen. You know what I mean? Is you could take a bad situation. Me, I was in YTC with a big hole in my foot, a hole in my hand. My parents living quite down south. I wasn't getting visit every week. I wasn't the most favorite amongst, you know, the lads, but I used to sing. Miss Weeks brought me into the Calypso competition, and from then, you know, is when I say, yeah, maybe this is the calling that I'm looking for, you know. I remember when I went my final day in court, I actually asked the magistrate to sentence me, because I don't think that was done by me. I mean, like, maybe some higher power was controlling my mouth at that point in time. I actually asked the magistrate to sentence me to 3 years in the youth training center. When she asked me why, I said, because, ma'am, that is the only way I see myself with a future and becoming something in life. The whole courtroom was shocked, like, everybody just spin around. I mean, my aunt Valerie Lovier, she spin and she watched me. My father was on the next side, I mean, he spin and he watched me. It might seem like downhill, you know what I mean? It might seem like, yo, we going and get be put away for 3 years on top of the year he was done away already. But, you know, you had to make the best out of your situations. You had to make the sun shine, you know what I mean? And even if time's tough, just go and get a hose and spray it in the air. You must see a rainbow, you know what I mean? You had to make your joy. I see youth men inside there who couldn't read and write too well and thing, you know. I wouldn't say they turn out scholars, but compared to where they was, yeah. I really think it mightn't be YTC that the youths need, but the youths need some form or fashion of solitude. They need some form or fashion of discovering the self, you know what I mean? Because plenty youths in both Trinidad and Tobago don't know the self, and they don't know the talent that they have, because they're just following the trend, you know? If singing is the trend, then let's all try and sing. If running is the trend because Olympics coming up, let's all try and be athletic, you know? And it's not so. All the whole of Trinidad and Tobago full up of talent. The whole world full up of talent, you know? It's just you, the individual, had to make up your mind and go and discover yourself like Jesus, go on your 40 days and 40 nights like Buddha, like Krishna. If you go through every religion, each and one of the majors, even Muhammad, all of them took that time to discover themselves, you know?